Hi, my name is Don Swigger with TVForMyRV.com. We have a 1998 Overland Laredo here that we have an old style square TV. We're going to take this TV out and replace it with a 23-inch LG high definition TV. Stay tuned for more. So now it's time to take the final plugs and screws out and pull this TV out to see what's going on. Okay, now. Some kind of ugly. We have the TV out and the cable's disconnected. We'll put this thing out of the way and see what we have to do next. Certainly not what I expected to find in here. I was hoping that this would be a nice finished wooden box and we could just screw the new TV in and go. But new challenges arise all the time. We're going to use a Bellow 8165 heavy duty articulating mount. It's available in either silver or black with articulating arms, tilt and swivel. The plan is to mount this on the side up here. That will allow the TV to come back here flush and be stowed for travel. When you park and you don't want to have the slide out, you'll be able to bring your TV out and display it at any angle that you can sit anywhere in the coach and position the TV for optimum viewing. Another interesting part, or convenient part, to the Bellow mounts, they come with a booklet and also an Installation for Dummies DVD. They come with a complete array of hardware, neatly packaged in a cellophane pack with all the appropriate screws and mounting hardware for your particular television. The way the Bellow mount works is you have an adapter plate which mounts on the back of the TV. It gets attached to the TV. The TV and bracket all slides down into place, and then there are two retaining screws to put in the top. So the next thing that we'll do is to go ahead and mount this on the back of the new television. One consideration that you have with the TVs is where the power and menu buttons are. On this TV, they're on the top. Some TVs are on the side. If you really get lucky, you might find one with the buttons across the bottom. But I think what we'll do is we're going to mount this TV close to the bottom of the compartment and put a filler strip in over the top. So now we'll go ahead and get to building the cabinet. While we were away, we built a plywood box to put in the empty hole where the old TV came out of. One thing you'll want to keep in mind is that there's a lot of possibility that these openings in your motorhome may not be square. They may not be level. You'll just have to pick some happy medium somewhere in there. I chose to try to keep this box fairly square so we don't have an even reveal the whole way around. We also left open access areas where you needed to get access to things that were in here. And now we'll put our trim ring up here that we made to give it a finished off look. The way these brackets work, the piece that's mounted permanent, this is like a socket. Okay, there's two small screws that come in from the top side to secure the TV after it's installed. So in order to put the TV in place, we need to remove these retaining screws. This is our 23-inch LG TV. It's high definition, widescreen. We chose this particular model because it fit nicely in the space that we have available. On the back side of almost every flat panel TV out there, you're going to find a bolt pattern of some sort. There are several standards. There's 75mm, 100mm, 100x200, and 200x200. This panel, this piece, is the adapter that allows you to set your TV down into the mount. There are four screws that hold this in place. There's some latitude here, so if you find that your TV is installed and it's not sitting level, you may need to move this plate around to adjust the level on your TV when you're finished. Also, when you get this where you want it, you want to take these screws out one at a time, put some Loctite on there so that they don't fall out while you're driving down the road. So we raise the TV up above the empty socket and line it up and drop it down. It should lock in place like a wedge. And now at this point, the TV is secured to the arm. We do need to put the two small screws in from the top. to make sure that it's locked in place. One of the nicest features about this is if you're boondocking and dry camping, you don't want to put the slide out for the night. You can swing the TV over to the side and still be able to see it from anywhere. But when you're all done and you're ready to travel, TV inserts back into the opening. I did design this so that the bottom of the TV, when the TV is placed back into the box, will actually rest on the lower edge of the compartment, so that as it is traveling, the entire weight of the TV is not actually on the bracket. It's going to sit somewhat on the bottom of the TV case itself. We made a block that screws into the bottom of the frame. It provides support for the TV. There's a T-nut in the back of the frame that this bolt threads into, tightens up and holds the TV against the box and supports it vertically. Okay, the TV's hooked up. We're pretty far from the nearest TV transmitter and it's doing its auto scan, so when it's finished we'll see how many channels we get. We received approximately 3 digital channels here off the air from local television stations. This is a high definition basketball game broadcast by ABC or ESPN. We also have a digital channel from the same station. This is not high definition, but it's an information sub-feed channel. And we're also getting to watch a NASCAR race on the Fox network. So you can see that your standard rooftop batwing antenna and the existing amplifier, you can watch high definition digital TV in your RV. Here's an example of what upgrading your old analog TV with a new digital high def TV can do for you. This is the same TV station, the same transmitter, and same broadcast. If this is you in some remote campground, look what a new high def TV can do for you. Get your new TV from TVformyrv.com.